children, today we are going to understand how to find out speed of sound in air by using resonance tube by two resonance position. So to find out velocity, we know that velocity depends upon frequency and difference in the length of the resonance. The formula for the same is V is equal to twice of frequency L2 minus L1, where L1 stands for length of air column for the first resonance. L2 stands for length of air column for the second resonance, and nu represents frequency of tuning fork. So by finding out this resonance position, we can calculate velocity. So resonance is the phenomena in which whenever the frequency of vibration of tuning fork matches with the frequency of the vibration of air column, we can hear the maximum sound. So I will show you the apparatus. Here we are having resonance tube. This resonance tube has first one this glass tube, and then there is another rubber tube, and you can see that both the tubes are connected from the bottom side. A liquid is, our water is filled in this tube, and whenever we take tuning fork, we are having various tuning fork. I will show you, like this is a tuning fork with the frequency 512 Hz. Likewise, we are having many other tuning forks, and we repeat this experiment with the help of all different tuning fork of different frequency. So whenever we hit this tuning fork on the rubber pad and put it over here above the surface of this glass tube, what happened that the air column inside the glass tube will start vibrating, and whenever the frequency of vibration of air column matches with the frequency of vibration of this tuning fork, the maximum amplitude of the sound wave happens and we hear the maximum sound, and that resonance can happen more than once. At certain length we achieve the first resonance position, and then later we keep changing the length of the water in this glass tube, and then we get the second resonance length. So I will show you that how we receive the maximum sound at the first resonance position. So the length of the water column, you can see here there is a meter scale attached, and at present my air column is between the length 13 or 14 centimeter. Let's say 14 centimeter is right now length of my air column. And if I will show you that on striking this tuning fork against the rubber pad and putting it over here, we will observe a maximum or the louder sound. Just observe this closely. Let me do it again. Okay, so this is the way we receive the sound, maximum sound, and this reading is noted down as the first resonance length, L1. Okay, this L1 we noted down twice by changing the water level falling and water level rising. We can keep changing the water level in the resonance tube in two manners. Either it will fall or it will rise. But the first resonance position will always occur at the same position. So we just verify our reading by doing it in two different methods, and then we get the mean value of it. Now we change the water level in the resonance tube, which is almost thrice the value of the first resonance length. That information we have from our theoretical studies, and by adjusting that length, again we do the same experiment. We put the tuning fork above the glass tube and observe the maximum sound. It means wherever we are getting the maximum sound, that position is defined as resonance position. And finding out these values, we put the value in this formula 2 nu L2 minus L1, and hence finally calculate the speed of sound in air, which comes near around 340 to 360 meter per second at room temperature. Thank you so much.